Hi guys. So today, as you can see from the setting, we're going to do something love related, okay? So this was a suggestion from one of my subscribers. Thank you so much. Interesting topic. So what we're exploring today in this pick a card is how is your future partner or spouse going to confess their feelings for you? Okay, so the question we're looking at is how is your future partner or spouse going to confess their love, their feelings for you? All right, and in front of you are three piles, pile one, pile two, and pile three. Pile one is the smoky quartz pyramid. Pile two is the rose quartz rose. Okay, and pile three is the clear quartz wand. All right, please pause your videos and pick your pile with the question in mind. Right, so let's start with pile one. Right, so pile one with the smoky quartz. Smoky quartz pyramid. Let's see, how is your person going to confess? All right, so first card, trust. This situation is calling for you to have faith. Wedding. This situation involves marriage. Page of Cups. Ace of Swords. Strength. A win-win outcome is forecast. Full moon in Libra. Okay. I hope you can see the cards. Yeah, that's good enough. Okay, so pile one, how is your future spouse or partner going to confess their feelings for you? I'm seeing a lot of pinks here. This is, you know, also pink, pink, pink. Okay, and yeah. Anyways, so pink is the color of love, and that's why I was noticing that, right? So the very first thing that I'm seeing with your person, pile one, is that, you know, this person is going to have some sort of a surprise awakening of feelings for you. All right, your future spouse or partner is going to have some sort of a sudden feeling of, you know, romantic feelings for you. It's like, it's something like, you know, they might be taken by surprise with these feelings, because, you know, if you see this card here, Page of Cups, this little kid looks a little surprised to see the fish in the bowl, right? And the heart is glowing, and there's a big wave here that you can see. you know, which means a wave of emotion, right? And when I pair that up with the Ace of Swords, it's like it's going to be a sudden realization for your person that they like you. Okay, it's possible that they might initially they might not have really realized it when they met you or something like that, but I don't know, maybe upon reflection, maybe later, this person I sense is suddenly going to awaken, you know, to the feelings they have for you. And they seem pretty strong with this wave here. It's like a big tidal wave, and all of a sudden the clouds clear and they can see the truth. So the very first thing I'm seeing is that your person is going to have a sudden realization about what feelings they have for you. All right? Now, I sense with this trust card that it's possible that your person might be someone who doesn't trust so easy. All right? Which is probably also the reason that they are a little surprised at their feelings, the overarching feelings they have for you, the intense emotion they have for you, because I am seeing a lot of emotion here, okay? I feel that this person has a bit of a problem trusting, and you know, it says this situation is calling for you to have faith. Something about your connection with this person is going to how do I say this, it's like they need to have faith in this. All right, it's almost like when I see the strength card here, what I'm seeing really is that maybe this person sort of looks up to you or something like that, because with the strength card, this is a very beautiful, calm, serene woman with the lion's head on her lap. And this is the strength card of the tarot. And you know, with this card, what it's telling me is that you know, this person might be looking up to you. Maybe you are someone who's a very close and mature friend to this person. Maybe you are a teacher or a mentor or a guide, just somebody they look up to, you know, someone who provides them with a lot of serenity. Someone who provides them with serenity, someone they look up to, someone they admire, someone they find very untouchable, you know, someone who is like put on a pedestal of sorts by this person. And with this lion resting on her lap, I sense that, you know, you are the only person who can tame this person. You know, they only somehow, something about you makes this person relax. Right? So I'm getting a kind of admiring energy. So it's possible this person might be in that kind of a relationship with you. Maybe, like I said, you know, as a friend or a student or something like that, because this is also a page energy here. So I do sense when I combine these two that, you know, this person might not have expected to have such intense feelings for you, and it would come as a bit of a revelation to them that they hold such deep feelings for you, pile one. Now, I do sense that this person definitely trusts you, okay? They do trust you. I don't think there is any issues with, you know, trust being the problem here. I think they trust you a lot. They depend on you. They value you. They admire you, right? But it's just that maybe this person feeling like they don't want to, you know, disturb this relationship you guys have. Like, you know, if it's like, let's say a teacher-student sort of guide-mentor sort of relationship, or just a, you know, a best friend or something like that. It's possible this person doesn't want to disturb that. I'm also getting that this person does have trust issues, your future spouse or partner. I do feel that this person has trust issues, and you know, it's not every day that they have realizations that they have deep feelings for someone so suddenly. So it's kind of going to throw them off track, I sense, when they know that they have such strong feelings for you, because you know, it's almost like this person feels a little insecure because you mean so much to them, and then now this added complication of love, right? So this is a very sweet energy, to be frank. And you know, they are asked to trust that this is going to be a win-win outcome. All right, so this person is asked to trust that this is something that they should go for, I sense. All right, and I do feel that, you know, after they balance themselves out a little bit, come to terms with their feelings for you and they get balanced in those feelings, this person is going to trust you enough to come and speak to you. Okay, I'm seeing that this person, it might take a bit of time for this person to come forward, I sense. I am seeing a little bit of waiting here. But it's almost like, you know, they have to really weigh their options before doing this. Okay, I also feel this person is someone you can trust. If you are, you know, if they come forward to you and they tell you that they love you, you know, you can trust this person. Because this person wants a wedding. This situation involves marriage. This is not a person who is going to, you know, want something casual with you. This is a person who's a very long-standing sort of person. With the strength card, the trust card, and the wedding card, I'm seeing that this person is a person who goes for long-term commitments. There is incredible strength, perseverance, and dedication to relationships within this person. Once they give their heart to you, this person is going to love you eternally, because I'm seeing the eternity symbol also over here. Okay, and this person is someone, your future spouse is someone who is going to kind of slightly put you on a pedestal, I feel. And when I look at this wedding card, I'm laughing because when I look at this wedding card, it's almost like this girl is looking at this guy and she's like, are we doing this? Is this guy really serious about this? Okay, and this guy is very serious indeed. Very, very serious about, very convinced that they want to marry you. All right, so it might come as a surprise for you, I sense, when this person tells you that they love you and that they want to go for a marriage. I sense this person is going to tell you quite soon in this connection that they want to get married to you, right? Because this person has very strong feelings. I am sensing that this person is someone, when they actually know that they love someone, they are very clear about what they want. And they are, with the Ace of Swords and the wedding card, I'm seeing that, you know, it's like, it's almost as though, you know, they are very clear after they, you know, kind of delve deep and know that they love you. This person is going to be very clear that they want a long-term commitment. They are not the kind of people, you know, who, like I said, you know, want something casual. Right now, with a win-win outcome is forecast, I sense that you are going to love this person equally. Okay, it's possible there might be this dynamic of, you know, being a little awkward at first, but there is equal love here and there is a marriage here. Okay, so you are required to go with your heart, to go with your intuition, to go with your feelings in the case of this person. Okay, now I am also getting that, you know, the way that this person's going to tell you, I'm actually getting that it's going to be quite sudden. All right, you might be taken by surprise. It's possible that you guys, you know, are in a certain friendship or a relationship of any sort, and all of a sudden, one day, this person is just going to like take you aside or something like that and just, you know, just tell you everything. You know, they are just going to, you know, go with the flow. And with the Ace of Swords, it's going to be like a revelation for you. It's possible that, you know, you yourself might be very surprised when they tell you this. You might be taken aback. But something about this, I sense maybe you might be someone who is harboring this feeling of love for them, but it is not necessarily romantic love. When they tell you that they love you, you are yourself going to feel this wave of emotion that you probably had suppressed because of the nature of this relationship. I do sense that you are the more mature party here. You are the one who's more patient, more mature. Not necessarily someone who is absolutely aware or something like that, but it's just this, there's a quality of unconditional love here. All right. It's possible that you just love that person anyways. Right. It does not matter what form the relationship is in. You have a lot of compassion and care for this person. I almost see this like, you know, Beauty and the Beast kind of a feeling that I'm getting over here. It's almost as though, you know, there is something about this person which is, you know, very a lot like a Leo. It's possible your person might be a Leo, I sense. Okay, or a Pisces. I'm getting Leo Pisces energies here. It's almost as though you know that you are the only person who can guide, guide and calm down this person. So you already, I sense, have this unconditional kind of love for this person. You might be having that. And I don't sense any sort of, you know, rush or fear or worry or anxiety from your side. It's almost as though just being in connection with this person is good enough for you. So when this person finally comes out and, you know, tells you this, you are going to be taken aback. And then, you know, then maybe your emotions are going to surge. And, you know, you would have clarity that, yes, I mean, this connection is something that you also want. This is an equal love is what I'm seeing. This is also a very strong love with the wedding card and the strength card. What I'm getting is that this is an eternal relationship. This is something that is going to last for a very long time. Eternity, the eternity symbol, right? So you are someone that inspires this person. You are someone they are very convinced about as well. You might wonder what convinces this person about you. It's possible that there might even be an age gap between you guys. Maybe that's the reason, you know, you might not be very confident about why this person is so feels so strongly about you, but there is an absolute conviction that this person will have once they realize their feelings. I also feel that, you know, this person is going to keep you as their inspiration. There's just something about you, there's something about your connection, there's something about your love that inspires this person, calms down this person. They have never met anybody like you, I sense, pile one. They just hold you in so much respect and esteem and love, all right? This person trusts you a lot. I'm sensing that it's almost as though they might be entrusting you with their deepest secrets. And it's like, you know, it's possible that you are their best friend, their counselor, their healer, their teacher, or maybe just anybody, you know, they kind of look up to. This person really holds you in a lot of esteem. This person has unconditional love. I sense with these two cards as well, the marriage and strength card, this is a relationship that is going to last for a very long time. The red roses are that of love. And the white roses are that of purity. This is a very pure, deep, spiritual sort of connection. It's probably even a connection that you guys have lived through lifetimes, which obviously you're not aware of, but it is something which has a rock solid foundation. It is a connection that has been going on for lifetimes and lifetimes, I sense. Which is the reason when your person realizes that, you know, they love you, that this person is not going to wait very long. You know, I'm not sensing that they will wait very long before they actually come and tell you about this. Because I feel that, you know, the only thing that will delay this connection might be some sort of trust issues that this person might have. It's possible they have it from, you know, some past connections. It's possible they want to, you know, tell you at the right time or something like that. All right. It's also possible that, you know, this person might think that they don't want to spoil this connection. There is also a sense that this person might feel that you might not reciprocate. And that's also another major thing that I'm getting from this trust card. Your person might have had it tough in the area of love, and so it's what I'm getting is that they might have a bit of a tussle within themselves before coming to you and telling you this, because they have been hurt, I sense, in love before, right? So it's possible your person might not immediately tell you about it, but I don't think they're going to be able to control it for very long. I also feel that you guys are perfect partners with each other. A win-win outcome is forecast. Full moon in Libra. Libra is also ruled by the planet Venus, which is the planet of love. It's also the planet of, it's also talking about balance here. So it's like an equal love. It's also something fated, I sense, because it's like a win-win outcome is already forecasted for this connection. So your person actually need not have any trust issues, because, you know, you guys are going to be in perfect synergy, in perfect compatibility with each other. And this is going to be a very long-term kind of a relationship, I sense. This is... this is a bond that will last for a very long time. So to recap, I feel that your person, pile one, is going to have a realization suddenly about what their feelings are. They might take some time to, you know, assimilate or process how they're going to come out with it. And when they do come out with it, it's going to be for keeps. This person will keep you very happy. It's this person, you would be this person's inspiration. Their muse is what I'm hearing, okay? And this is a relationship that's going to stay for a very long time, because it has a very firm foundation. It has a very equal and balanced love between both of you. All right, so I sense that, you know, in terms of setting, I do feel that, you know, it might be you know, in I don't know, I mean, if I look at this card, I feel this is the card that's telling me most about you know, how it's how or where they're going to actually tell you. This card and this card, it's almost like this person is going to be like at their wit's end when they come to you. They just come to you with full trust, and it might be in some room or something with a view of some window. I'm seeing clouds and mountains. I'm seeing clouds here, maybe mountains here. But the main thing that I'm getting from these two cards is that your person's going to be sort of like defeated trying to, you know, analyze this connection. And they just want to come and trust you. They would trust you enough to come and tell you their feelings. So it's possibly going to be, you know, in a setting of some room with a view. I also see some sort of a Cupid here. So there are angels looking after this connection. And I feel this person is literally going to fall into your arms. You know, they will not be able to help it anymore. They cannot control their feelings anymore. And I sense that, you know, this person is going to just go with the flow and trust their feelings to you. And I sense that you're going to be very gentle with this person, you know, with this woman here. I'm seeing that, you know, you're going to be very gentle, you're going to be very understanding, and you will accept. And that's going to make this person fall more and more deeper in love with you, because you have so much grace and so much elegance. And I don't know, I just keep getting all these words from your person side. I think I'm channeling them or something. This person finds you so graceful, so elegant, so calm, serene, charming. Wow, okay. So this person is deeply, deeply in love with you. I don't think this person would even realize how much they love you, but it is going to hit them. I sense a lot of divine intervention here, because I see the eternity symbol, I see the angels here, and then I'm also seeing this Ace of Swords as some sort of an epiphany, you know, some sort of a bolt out of the blue for this person to make them realize that, yes, you know, this is the person, you know, you love. Yeah, it's possible that, you know, for some of you, that it's not necessary that, you know, you are very for some of you, I said, it's not necessary that you are very close to that person also. It's possible it's just another official or casual relationship, but something about this person realizing it, it's like, you know, it was always there, but, you know, it suddenly sort of, you know, bursts open. So maybe this person might have had something like a love at first sight, but they didn't get it at that point of time. But I sense maybe you got it somewhere, but you were like, you know, you were not in any kind of a mode to label this connection. It's possible for some of you that that's how it happened. But it's almost like this person's kind of, I find it a little funny, because, you know, it's like this person probably knew when they first saw you on a very subconscious level that you are the one. But they kind of suppressed it somewhere because they have some trust issues or something like that. And I feel that, you know, when it hits them, it's going to be like a bolt of lightning. It's like everything makes sense to this person. And then, you know, they would be like, oh my God, I mean, you know, it's almost like something is revealed to them with this Ace of Swords. Okay, so this is what I'm getting. There is definitely going to be a marriage or a long-term commitment here, I sense. Okay, and this is a win-win outcome. This situation is already resolved according to the universe, because I am seeing a lot of divine intervention in this pile. So I feel that the universe has already kind of brought you guys together. Because it is, this is a relationship that is supposed to be worked out. It is already resolved. It is already a win-win situation. So if you have any issues with trusting this person, then don't be, because this person is the one. Okay, this was nice. This was very interesting. So let's see what our second pile says. Right, so pile number two with the rose quartz rose. How will your future partner or spouse confess their feelings for you? Attraction. Codependency. Balance, spirituality and practicality. Full moon in Pisces. Knight of Swords. Six of Pentacles. Ace of Pentacles. Okay. Right, so pile number two. I sense that your person, please excuse my throat, it's a little raw today. This is going to start with some sort of an attraction between both of you. All right, when I see the attraction card, it says you attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. It's possible with this, I am sensing that you guys might be at a distance from each other. Okay, and it might be someone you meet online, it might be somebody you meet briefly at a certain place and then you have to part, but there will be time for you guys to get to know each other and get attracted. There is going to be a lot of attraction in this connection, I sense, and a bit of time for this attraction to grow. I'm also sensing that this could be a connection which would first get into a relationship possibly, and then go on to something more. All right, now I do feel that there with the codependency card, it says addictions are affecting your romantic life. So it's possible that, either you or your future spouse or partner might be having a tendency to get codependent on each other. All right. There is a whole lot of attraction here. There is a whole lot of, feelings over here. But there is also a sense of codependency, possibly because, maybe you guys might be at a distance, maybe you're not able to meet each other so frequently. There might be a sense of codependency here, either from your side or from their side. And you are asked to come into balance with that. You are asked to heal that. It's possible it's your person who has that, or it's possible you have that. But both of you are advised to heal that codependency so that you can go to the next level of this connection. When they say balance, spirituality and practicality, and then we have Six of Pentacles, which is also about balance, all right? So I sense with this card here, it says balance, spirituality and practicality. I sense this is a sacred connection. This is a divine soul-based connection. There's a lot of attraction, intense chemistry also, I feel. Right, but I do feel that this would require either them or you or both of you to work on your inner self, to balance spirituality and practicality. Right, spirituality might be making you have very intense feelings towards this person, or they might be having very intense feelings towards you, but you need to be practical as well. You need to balance the spiritual aspect of this connection as well as the practical aspect of this connection, I sense. Right? Now, I feel that your person is, going to be working on that as well. I do feel that this person might be a little conflicted about why they are so intensely attracted to you. Okay, I'm seeing very intense attraction, very intense connection and love from this person's side, almost bordering on a codependency, which they can't understand, I sense, with the balance, spirituality and practicality. It's almost like, it's the sign of Pisces. So as you know, with the symbol of Pisces, one fish swims down, the other one swims up. So it would be up to your person to decide which direction they want to swim. Do they want to get drowned in the waters of intense emotion because it's a sacred connection, intense connection, soul connection, or do they want to go absolutely practical and absolutely disbelieve this connection? I do feel that your person might have a tendency to go either which way. Sometimes they feel that this is the be all and end all of all connections. They're very intense about it, very motivated, very much in love. And on a split side, you know, this person might be absolutely practical, saying that no, you know, there's nothing like this. It's absolutely impractical to go for a connection like that. So I'm seeing some sort of a back and forth kind of an energy from your person's side, pile two, and that might cause you to have codependency issues as well, right? Because when a person is not sure, it kind of leaves the other person a little confused, right? So I feel your person needs to balance out their emotions in this connection. They need to come into balance, right? They need to understand that spirituality and practicality can both coexist. You don't have to take only just one road. I sense that this person will take some time to, you know, get into balance with these energies that they have. And then I sense that, you know, this person is going to come very fast with the Knight of Swords. I sense this person is going to come very fast to communicate, to very swift movement forward to communicate their feelings to you. All right. And also give you something which is a tangible offer in terms of relationship. It could be anything. It could be, you know, the next level of a relationship, moving in, marriage, whatever it is. But this is a tangible offer. This is not something in the air. Your person, once they come into balance pile two, are going to tell you, I don't know why I'm getting that this person... Excuse me if I'm laughing, but it's really sweet stuff, okay? And it's really, really, I can feel these energies. It's almost like this person's been controlling themselves in telling you exactly what they feel. And as you can see, these are very intense feelings that your person would be feeling. And because they're trying to come into balance, they might not have confessed their feelings to you so soon. But when they come into balance, it's almost like this person is... is going to kind of tell you their feelings in rapidly, you know, like without even thinking, almost in a kind of anger because they have been holding on to these feelings so long. This person's frustrated holding on. And with the Knight of Swords, I feel they won't even think before saying it. They will just leap in. And it might take you by surprise, I sense. You know, because you're like, oh, you know, it's fast and furious, you know. That's the sentence I'm getting. Look at this person's face, you know, they're almost like irritated that they have to wait so long. But this is how your person's going to tell you one fine day when they're feeling very upset or moody or emotional about this connection. They're just gonna probably either come to you or pick up the phone or something like that and just let you know there and then. Very clearly. This knight is also holding a sword and the sword is shining. So this is a very clear communication that's going to come from your person about the confession of their love. It might not be very soft and sweet and romantic. I sense that this could be something like, you know, almost as though this person's like frustrated waiting and they're like, you know, I love you, right? Okay. So this is what I'm getting. And I sense, you know, with this man laughing here, you're going to be a little, you know, you might find it a little funny or something like that. Okay, but obviously you will accept it, I feel, you know, because you would be very happy that this person has finally come out of their conundrum, come out of their dilemma, and that they have decided. I feel you would need to have a bit of patience with your person. They are asking you to enjoy the moment, right? Because this connection is going to happen. This person just needs some balancing to do. But you are advised to enjoy each day as it comes with your person and not get codependent on them. Don't let them become an addiction, all right? because this is something that, you know, your person is definitely going to come forward and tell you. It's just that, you know, they need to do some internal work, possibly shadow work, I'm seeing. You know, there are two sides to their personality. They need to balance those. And till then, you know, there's no point you having heartache about them not deciding. Remember, it is not going, it's not about you. It's about them, right? It's something within them that is not letting them, you know, go forward for this connection immediately. You sense the attraction. I feel that you will be sensing a lot of attraction from them, chemistry from them, feelings, love, everything. But you might not be able to do much at a certain point of time because, you know, it's your person's work, basically. It's your person who has to work on themselves to get themselves in this balance. I also feel after this person confesses their feelings to you, this person might also ask, you know, they look like a slightly traditional type of person. So they might ask your parents also for your hand in marriage. Because this Six of Pentacles is generally a card of family, generations, ancestry, stuff like that, right? So I sense that, you know, they might ask an elderly person to actually, you know, for your hand in marriage, for blessings, or you might even, if not them asking for your hand in marriage, it's possible that after the initial confession, you guys might, you know, share the news with your near and dear ones very quickly and maybe have something like a meet the parents thing if it is marriage that you guys decide. If it is not, it might just be an introduction to the family, to their, you know, to their immediate family or their friends or something like that. There is a sense of celebration and occasion over here as well. Okay, so this is pretty much what I'm getting in terms of how your person is going to confess their feelings for you, pile two. Okay, so very interesting stuff. Whenever it happens, I mean, I don't really want to get into timelines, but I sense that maybe an year, you know, take it as it resonates, depending on your age, maybe an year you might meet this person. I also feel that your person's zodiac sign might be Pisces or maybe an air sign, Libra, Aquarius or Gemini. You also might be any of those signs, so please take it as it resonates. So this is what I'm getting. Okay. Right, so let's go to pile three with the clear quartz wand. Very soon, clearly decide what you want so that it comes to you now. Romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. Your hard work is paying off. The sun. Queen of Swords, Page of Swords, right. please give me a minute. Okay, so pile three, how will your person, your future spouse or partner, confess their romantic feelings for you, their love for you? So what I'm getting is that I feel here that this person is going to have feelings for you for some time before they confess it. I feel you might have feelings for them and they might have feelings for you. There are some very intense romantic feelings that I'm seeing in this connection. All right. I sense, however, with the Page of Swords and the Queen of Swords here, I feel that your person might not really be a romantic. Your person is probably someone who is a bit wary of, going with the flow of their emotions. Because it says that, you know, your feelings are real and worth exploring. And then we have Page of Swords and Queen of Swords. It's almost like, you know, your person might be closed off to you initially. And it's even possible for pile three that your person, your future spouse or partner, might come across as aloof and distant from you initially, maybe even guarded and wary from you because they're feeling this romantic feelings. It's almost like a defense mechanism for your person, I sense, you know. It's like, it's possible this person has been, you know, has had a little bit of a tough run in terms of love, and that's probably the reason why, you know, this person is not very comfortable showing their emotions or even feeling them for that matter. I'm sensing a lot of blockage here from your person's side initially, pile three. Okay. Now I also feel with the Queen of Swords and the Page of Swords here, there is a sense of an age gap, right? It's possible that you might meet in some sort of a work situation and they might be either your senior, your junior, they, or vice versa. Please apply it as it fits. It's possible you have a superior subordinate relationship or something like that, or even an age gap for that matter. So it makes this person question their feelings even more and be more guarded about their feelings actually. But the feelings are very romantic. I'm sensing a lot of attraction, chemistry, love. And this is a beautiful image, right? It's like this person really wants to, express their love. It's like there's so much of passion here. There's so much of gentleness. There's so much of soft, romantic feelings that this person has for you that they possibly might get a little guarded and want to kind of block this connection. All right? Now it says clearly decide what you want so it comes to you now. So this person, I sense, will take some time to gain some sort of clarity about the situation. All right. I do feel that, you know, when they decide that they want love like this, then this person is going to move very fast and very soon. All right. I also feel with the Queen of Swords, this person is not very used to letting their feelings take the lead. It's almost as though they don't want to lose control, and that's why they don't want to flow with their emotions. It's almost like, you know, they keep everything ice cold around them. Maybe because this person has been hurt in the past, I sense. I'm seeing Capricorn energies here, new moon in Capricorn. Your hard work is paying off. So I sense that this person is, you know, has had a bit of a tough run when it comes to the area of love, because Capricorn, the ruling planet of Capricorn is Saturn, and Saturn tests you in the initial part of its transit. Saturn tests you in whatever area it falls in. So I sense with this card here, your person has been tested in the area of love, and that's probably the reason why, you know, this person is so reticent. This person is so guarded about flowing with their emotions, right? So I feel it's possible your person's zodiac might be Capricorn or some sort of an earth energy. I'm getting earth energy and air energy. So either Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. Either they are or you are, right? I'm seeing that. Now I feel that, you know, your person will take some time to decide what they want to do about this connection, because the feelings are very intense. I do feel it's a very romantic, gentle, almost otherworldly kind of love is what I'm getting. It's almost like, you know, when your person is with you, they get lost in another world altogether. They want to, you know, like spend so much quality time with you. But this person is like, I think would be, you know, not even able to trust their own feelings or let go to some extent and flow with their feelings initially. But once this person decides that this is what they want, okay, and I sense that they will decide quite rapidly, because these feelings would start blooming, I feel, with the roses here, flowers here, and so much of abundance, trees and everything. This is something that this person cannot control for very long, I sense, right? So once this person decides, they are going to come to you, you know, absolutely clear and very, very joyful about their feelings. With the Sun card, I'm literally seeing like a childlike imagery here. It's almost like this person, you know, this kid is coming on a white horse. It's almost like a knight in shining armor with so much happiness, so much joy, because, you know, they have fought their internal battles. And this is your future spouse or partner taking a leap of faith towards you, bursting with love, bursting with joy, and some sort of effervescent energy about this person. Okay, there is so much of excitement, enthusiasm, childlikeness, a childlike kind of an energy here. Innocence even, you know. I'm seeing this as a beautiful card. It's almost like, you know, from the darkness, your person comes into the sun. So when your person comes to you, I sense the way they're going to confess it to you is going to be with a lot of enthusiasm, pile three. All right. It's almost like it's possible even you are a person who is quite guarded, who is not used to expressing emotions. Okay, it can be a vice versa situation also over here, where maybe you are someone who is kind of distant and cold, and you know, your person sees your external personality and gets a little guarded, you know, and doesn't express all these romantic feelings that they want to express. But I sense, you know, that your person, once they decide that, you know, you are what they want, this Queen of Swords energy is not going to deter them. This one is going to literally sweep you off your feet. I'm literally seeing that, okay? I mean, here is the Queen of Swords saying, okay, do this, do that. I'm going to be all armored up, right? And then this person is running full tilt right into her. Right? So it's almost like, you know, this is fire and ice, fire and ice. It's possible you are the person who is, maybe the air sign Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. This one might even be a fire sign, Leo, Sagittarius or Aries. These are two starkly opposite energies. So either this is, your person who's coming to you. One of you is obviously going to be the one to confess here. This is either your person coming to you, if you are the one like this, or this is you even coming to your person if they are like this. Because I am sensing that kind of an energy. It's possible in this pile you might be the one to confess to your person, if you are the one in this energy. Alright. And this person is almost like expecting it or wanting it or something. There is an arrogant air about this person. But whatever, I do feel that it's going to be in a burst of joy, excitement, fun, and innocence when this happens. It's possible this confession of their feelings might happen in the daytime, maybe somewhere around noon or something like that, where maybe you guys are in an external setting or something like that, maybe a garden or a rooftop where you can see flowers, you can see the sun, and suddenly this person comes out and just lets you know with all their enthusiasm, maybe even use flowery words, I sense, to tell you how much they love you. I don't know how you are going to react. I sense maybe you are going to be a little taken aback. I feel you might even you might even be a little guarded with this kind of a burst of enthusiasm because you are not used to it. It's possible because I'm seeing Capricorn energy here, sort of, and generally Saturn is a stern planet, right? I'm seeing you in a bit of a stern stance, right? So it's possible you might be a little taken aback and guarded when this person tells you, but you are also asked to decide, when this person actually comes to you. It's possible you have not explored your feelings till that time for this person, but you are asked to decide what you want. Do you want to be with this person? And obviously we're talking about a future spouse or partner, which means that you will decide for them, right? But you are asked to clearly decide what you want. Because I'm sensing this as your person who's like fully trusting you and telling you what they feel, and you also having feelings for them, but somewhere being a little guarded whether you can handle all this energy. Do you even have those kind of emotions? Maybe you might have been closed off for some time. Pile 3 might not even be expecting a love like that, With the Capricorn card here, the hard work is paying off. I feel that, it's like you might have had it tough also in the area of love, and you might be closed off to it. And now it's like whatever you invested in love in the past, it's all going to pay off to you. It's possible you might meet this person a little later than what you expect. And maybe at that time you are feeling that, there might not be anybody for me or something like that. Some negative energy there, okay? But this card here is saying that you are going to get rewarded for your efforts by this person coming in. There's a very strong feeling, and please take it as it resonates. It might be your person or it might be you, but one person in this connection is going to be very serious. Sort of closed off emotionally, and the other one I sense is going to be all about love and joy and expression, and somewhere this person is needed for the other person to get them into balance, because I think one of you, either you or them, might have become a little too closed off because of the Saturnian energies. Because maybe you guys went through something quite intense, and that's something that didn't work out in the past. So I really feel you are going to be rewarded with this beautiful, joyful person, as well as a joyful connection going ahead. Something that is very romantic, something that is very joyful. I sense lighthearted times, I sense romance, I sense love, I sense passion. I mean, and I also sense a sort of playfulness to this pile as well. Okay, it's almost like your life is going to be very different with this person in it, because they are going to reintroduce you to your inner child, to your inner joy. I sense that's what I'm feeling with these cards here. You know, it's almost like, you know, you are encouraged to give this connection a chance, to, you know, decide what you want so that it comes to you. Do you want this? Or do you feel you deserve something like this, pile three? If you choose joy, if you choose love over closing yourself off or feeling unworthy of love, then maybe it might not happen. But this is hanging on your decision, I sense. All right, you will have to make a decision, pile three, when this person comes into your life. Do you want to go for this or not? Because if you do, if you come out of this energy of Queen of Swords and Page of Swords, you know, I feel that, you know, you are going to have some beautiful, romantic, sensuous, attraction, chemistry. I mean, I'm seeing so many things. I'm even seeing holidays and vacations being taken with, you know, you taking those kind of breaks with your person. I mean, I'm seeing a lot of things. We're not looking into all of that right now, but you know, we're looking at how they are going to, you know, confess their feelings to you. And I feel this is how they are going to do it. It's up to you, pile three, to figure out what you want. Do you want this person? No. It's also possible for some of you that this person might have, like, you might have an age gap with this person, or maybe in some official capacity they might be a little lesser or something. Maybe that is what is going to make you you know, think again about whether you want to or not. But you are advised that in terms of love, don't let your mind rule. Go with your heart is what I'm getting. All right, trust a little. Trust that love can come to you, and it will. You know, I am seeing it quite, and your hard work will pay off, because, you know, I am seeing that Capricorn, the Saturn being the ruler of Capricorn, will give you this reward of, you know, a beautiful connection, a beautiful relationship in the future with your spouse. Right, I am assuming that since we're talking about your spouse or partner, you will agree to it. But I do see some sort of resistance or hesitation either from your side or from their side. So please let me know how it goes whenever it happens. But it was amazing doing this reading for you guys. Thank you so very much for all your likes and subscribes. I'm really, really loving hearing your comments and your suggestions. I know I have quite a few of them, but I will, I'm going, you know, I'm covering them one by one. I will get to you, but I have a pretty big list as of now, which is the reason I keep recording every 2 days, because I have quite a bit of a list to cover. But rest assured, I will. And please keep the comments coming. Thank you so much for your interest. Thank you so much for your viewership. I am loving this journey. Thank you. Bye-bye.